Good morning, students. Welcome back to the class. So we have done with differentiation concepts. Under that, we have studied many types of differentiation. So what are the main topics we have studied under differentiation for the second year concepts? So in differentiation, the first topic what we studied is chain rule, that is differentiation of function with respect to function. And the next one is called implicit. Okay, before implicit, we have studied something called as inverse trigonometric function differentiation, then implicit, then after implicit we studied something called as log differentiation. So logarithmic differentiation is done. Then the fourth one is going to be parametric. So under parametric we have differentiation of function with respect to function. This is also been done. Now after studying this, we have something called as second order derivative. This is also done. And the last topic was mean value theorems. So these are the topics which is covered under the topic of differentiation. So now on Sunday you have a test on maths. So what I will do here, instead of starting the new topic today, okay, now I will ask you to just let us go for a revision of this chapter today. So it's a revision class. It's purely concentrated on your examination. So that means what I will do here, I will just tell you what are the previous year examination, what are the questions from these concepts appeared in the previous year examination. This will help you a lot, let me tell you. Okay, so what I will do here, I will start from 2014, okay, till 2020, whatever the papers have been done. So I will just go through only this chapter we are going to discuss today. So it's a revision class which will be helpful for you. I know yesterday I have given you a topic of relation functions. Okay, then I thought it's better if I give a revision and then continue, which will be helpful for you for the test. So let us start today's revision class. So I'm going to start the discussion from 2014. So what I will do here is from 2014 onwards, okay, till 2020, that means till the the previous examination what your seniors batch have written, okay. Now till that I will discuss everything from this chapter of differentiation. So what I will do, first let us take 1 mark problem, let us discuss, okay. So we will discuss 1 mark, 2 mark, 3 mark and 5 mark problem. Like this we will go for a discussion, okay. So first let us start with the discussion for 1 mark problems. 1 mark problems. So the first one, that was in 2014. So in 2014 they have given a problem called as, if y is equal to log of sin x, then find dy by dx. Quite easy for us, we know. As I said already, a problem of chain rule will appear in 1 mark in the first main. Fine, okay. So y equal to log of sin x, so log sin x. So 2 times we need to differentiate this. So dy by dx equal to, first for log, so log will be 1 by x. Differentiation of log x will be 1 by x multiplied by differentiation of sin x will be cos x. Not to leave here, you can continue one more step. Cos x by sin x will be equal to cot x. It's so simple now. Okay, now let's get into the next paper. So in the next, so see what happens is, every year 2 papers, one is annual and one is supplementary. Clear? So this is 2014 annual examination, now supplementary. Now in supplementary, they have given a problem called as, if y is equal to cos of 1 minus x, then find dy by dx. So how to differentiate this now? First for cos, then for 1 minus x. Right. Then dy by dx equal to, differentiation of cos will be minus sine of 1 minus x multiplied by differentiation of 1 will be 0, differentiation of minus x will be minus 1. So minus into minus will be plus sine of 1 minus x. So remember this minus sign here. Got it? Now let's move on to the next. So 2014 papers were discussed. Now let's move on to the next one, that is 2015. So in 2015 we have a problem dy by dx equal to, we need to find dy by dx if y is equal to sine of x square plus 5. We need to find dy by dx if y equal to sine of x square plus 5. So dy by dx, it's so simple, first for sine, then for x square plus 5. What is differentiation of sine? Cos. So cos of x square plus 5 multiplied by differentiation of x square will be 2x and differentiation of 5 will be 0. So answer is simply 2x multiplied by cos of x square plus 5. This is from 2015 annual examination. Now supplementary. So let us take the supplementary paper based on this. So on this supplementary, it's a problem based on dy by dx. Y is given as cos of root x. Just notice, students. Now it is fixed actually. Okay. So one mark, one form of chain rule has to be given. It's compulsory. Okay. So let's go for it. Dy by dx. First for cos, then for root x. Differentiation of cos, minus sine of root x multiplied by differentiation of root x 1 by 2 root x. Is it difficult now? We have crossed so difficult, the level of difficulty in such a way that now these are nothing for us now. And if you have really practiced from the worked example, from the home exercise, then definitely you will not feel the heat. These are so simple for any students now. Now, let's go to 2016 annual examination. So let's go for it. So in 2016, they have given something. Y is equal to a to the power 1 by 2 log of 4 cos x. A bit different one so far. We never studied anything like this. Okay, so this has to be simplified. A property of log has to be applied. Okay, so remember. So let us start the discussion based on this. First you identify. See, first thing, it's in the form of a bar x. That's done. Okay, so half is a constant, we'll retain. You have to differentiate this. But the base is 4. Now that we cannot differentiate directly. So for this, we need to apply change of base property, then go for differentiation. So let us simplify. A to the power half, if I apply change of base, log of cos x by log 4. Base A, you can write it, or without that also it's fine. Now let us go for differentiation. So dy by dx equal to, first is a power x. So a power log of cos x by log 4. This is differentiation of a power x is a power x multiplied by log a. Fine. Now for this, in this, first of all, 1 by 2 is a constant. So first we are going to write it. And 1 by log 4 is also a constant. So let's retain. Now the remaining is log of cos x, 1 by cos x. That is for log. Now differentiation of cos will be minus sin x. Okay. So don't feel it's difficult at all. It's not at all difficult. You have to understand the concept first. Okay. So we cannot differentiate directly. So apply change of base property and simplify this. And now let's go to next 2016 annual exam we did. So let's go for the supplementary examination. So what is given is, so in supplementary they said y is equal to tan of 2x plus 3. Then find something called as dy by dx. So differentiate both sides. So first for tan, then for 2x plus 3. Differentiation of tan, secant square x in place of x, 2x plus 3 multiplied by differentiation of 2x will be 2 and 3 will be 0, or simply 2 multiplied by secant square of 2x plus 3. Okay. Now let's go to the next 2017. In 2017 March, okay, that is a board examination, annual examination, okay. So they have given y is equal to cos of root x, then find we have done this already, it's repeated one now. Okay, so dy by dx equal to minus sine of root x multiplied by 1 by 2 root x, first for cos then for root x. Then in the supplementary examination, they have given y is equal to sine of x square, then find dy by dx. So dy by dx will be cos of x square multiplied by 2x. Okay, now let's go to the next. The next one is, okay, the next one, 2018. So it's 2018 annual examination. So annual examination, that is on March. Y is equal to e power x cube, then find dy by dx. So first it's in the form of e power x multiplied by differentiation of x cube will be 3x square. I know you'd be, if you've already revised this chapter, if you already practiced okay, from home exercise problem, you will never feel the heat at all. You'll feel it, what kind of problem is there giving? It is looking so simple for us. This will come to your mind only if you have already prepared yourself. Okay, so let's go for the next. Fine students, and now just a second, I will let you know the problems which were given in 2019 and 2020. So in 2019, just a minute, I'm just looking out for some material. Fine, I got it. 2019 paper, sorry for that. So in 2019, okay, now let's come to 2019. So annual examination, that is on March. Y is equal to sine of x square plus 5, then find dy by dx. So again notice, dy by dx will be equal to cos of x square plus 5, that is differentiation of sine, and differentiation of x square will be 2x and 5 will become 0. Fine, so that's about 2019 paper. So if you're looking into the last year, that is this year only, for the academic year 2020, now they have given something called as y is equal to tan of root x, then find dy by dx. Look at that, first for tan then for root x. So dy by dx will be secant square of root x multiplied by 1 by root x. So that's how the things will be in 1 mark students. So starting from 2014, that is the year when this NCERT syllabus was started. So from there till here, till the previous examination, I've discussed every 1 mark problem on chain rule, that is in 1st May. So just go through. Okay, and you will you can understand these concepts, right? And now I think you're in a stage to write down the problems based on chain rule. So 1 mark in the final examination will be based on chain rule. Now let us go to problems, 2 mark problems actually. Now so we'll discuss 2 mark problem based on this. Now so in 2014, a problem is given. So your problem number 15 in 2014, if y plus sine y is equal to cos x, then find dy by dx. We need to find it. Fine. So first recognize the type on which it's based. It's a function of y, it's a term of y, that means it's a problem based on implicit. First recognize it. Fine. So differentiation of y, dy by dx, differentiation of sine y, cos y multiplied by dy by dx, and differentiation of cos x, minus sine x, we need to find dy by dx. So let us take dy by dx common. 1 plus cos y is equal to minus sin x. Then dy by dx equal to minus sin x by 1 plus cos y. That's all. Right. Please do not simplify it further. I know in some problem I have explained the simplification from submultiple angles. But here it's not possible. This is a function of x. This is a function of y. No, you cannot simplify it further. Please stop writing and just leave it. Got it? So, in 2 marks, they will give you 2 problems actually. Okay? So, 1 mark, 1 problem, 2 mark, 2 problems they will be giving you. Right? So, now the next one is problem number 16. If y is equal to x to the power x, then find dy by dx. Y equal to x power x, function to the power function. So, it's a problem based on logarithmic differentiation. So, apply log first. So, log y is equal to log of x power x can be written as x log x. Now differentiate. Differentiation of log y, 1 by y, dy by dx. Differentiation of x log x, product rule, x multiplied by differentiation of log x, 1 by x plus log x multiplied by differentiation of x will be 1. Eliminate this, or dy by dx equal to y multiplied by 1 plus log x. The last step is to replace y. The value of y is x power x multiplied by 1 plus log x. So, when I am going through this revision, okay, and if you are able to recollect the steps which you already learned, then you can just, it's understood that yes, you have learned the concept, you are ready with the concepts, okay, and now these things are quite easy for you. So, when I am explaining, you should be able to go through everything in mind, okay. So, let's have the next one. This is 2014 paper, so let's move to the next. Okay, so in the next exam, so it's actually June 2014, that is supplementary examination in 2014. So what they've given us, problem number 15. Problem number 15 is root x plus root 5 is equal to root 10, then find dy by dx. So again, a term of y is given, so implicit differentiation 1 by 2 root x plus 1 by 2 root y dy by dx, and here this will be 0. It's actually a prove the problem, plus root of y by x equal to 0. This is what we need to prove, right? Okay, so let us simplify. 1 by 2 root y into dy by dx equal to minus 1 by 2 root x. Eliminate to shift root y here, so dy by dx equal to minus of root y by root x. This is nothing but, whatever is nothing but, this is nothing but the y which is given to, sorry, we need to prove that, right? Sorry. Shift this one to left hand side. So, dy by dx plus root y by root x equal to 0. Okay. So, this is about 2000. And one more problem is there. Supplementary examination of 2014. Y is given as log x whole power cos x, then find dy by dx. This is given in the supplementary of 2014. So, function to the power function, so log should be applied. Log y is equal to log of log x whole to the power cos x. Whatever is there on the right side, for that log is applied. Now, cos x multiplied by log of log x, product rule for these two. So, differentiation of log y, 1 by y dy by dx. So, applying the product rule, log x, differentiation of log x, differentiation of log x is 1 by log x multiplied by 1 by x. First for log, then for log x. Close it. Plus log of log x multiplied by differentiation of cos x will be minus sin x. So, let's go for the simplification of this. So, dy by dx equal to y multiplied by cos x y, x log x minus, you have a minus sign here, so write that in the beginning. So, minus into plus will be minus sin x multiplied by log of log x. Fine. The last step, replace the value of y. Y is equal to log x whole power cos x. So, try to understand, students. So, for 2 mark, one problem is from implicit, one problem is from logarithmic differentiation. Fine, let's move on to the next paper. So in the next, that is 2015 March. Okay, so the problem is given as x square plus xy plus y square equal to 100, then find dy by dx. So clearly you can notice it's a problem based on implicit. So let us go for differentiating this. Differentiation of x square 2x, xy by product rule, right? So x into differentiation of y, that is dy by dx, plus y into differentiation of x, that will be 1, plus differentiation of y square 2y multiplied by dy by dx. 100 is a constant, so it will become 0. So collect the terms of dy by dx and take common. So on taking common from these two, the remaining is x plus 2y, and these two terms has to be shifted. So minus 2x minus 1. So further, this can be written as dy by dx equal to minus of 2x plus y by 2y plus x. It's done. Now, there is one more problem actually. Problem number 15 is given to us. Here, what is problem number 15 is given as? Differentiate x plus 1 by x with respect to x. This is not at all a problem based on chain rule. It's a direct one. Okay. So it's quite simple for us. Differentiation of x will be 1. Differentiation of 1 by x will be minus 1 by x. Got it? Hope you're able to follow easily, students, and you will feel easy only if you're already practiced, if you're already ready with that concept. Okay. Then only it's possible to feel it easy. Fine. Okay, students, now let's move on to supplementary examination of 2015. So 2015 supplementary, they have given something. So problem number 15 is usually based on this. So if y is equal to log of log x to base 7, then find dy by dx. You cannot differentiate directly because the base is 7, so apply change of base property. So y is equal to log of log x. Okay, this is the thing which I have taken here to the base a by log 7 to base a. Students, if you have forgotten the change of base property, so log of a to base b can be written as log a to base c by log b to base c. Remember an important one, okay, from the log concept. Now we have applied the property, so now let's differentiate. Here 1 by log 7 is a constant. Let's keep it as it is. Now differentiation of log x. So first we'll apply it for this log, then 1 by log x. When you're differentiating this, this should be taken as x. Multiplied by differentiation of log x will be 1 by x. It's done. Now, we have one more problem here. The next one, we have problem number 16. If y is equal to secant inverse of 1 by 2x square minus 1, then find dy by dx. I said one problem is from implicit and one problem is from log. Suddenly they changed a bit. Okay. So has to be done by substitution because this is inverse. So the best substitution, let me put x equal to cos theta. You will notice y is cos theta later on, and that is because of this term in the denominator. So y will be equal to secant inverse of 1 by 2 cos square theta minus 1. This is secant inverse of 1 by cos 2 theta. 1 by cos is secant 2 theta. That was the reason why we put x equal to cos theta, because this should be converted in terms of secant. So the final remaining will be 2 theta. If x equal to cos theta, then theta will be equal to cos inverse x. Replace here 2 cos inverse x. That is the simplest form of y. We have not yet differentiated. We have just simplified and we got it as 2 cos inverse x. Now we will differentiate. So dy by dx equal to 2 multiplied by differentiation of cos inverse minus 1 by root of 1 minus x square. Fine, students. Let's move to the next. The next one is 2016 March. The problem was if y is equal to secant inverse of 1 by 2x square minus 1, then find dy by dx. This was problem number 15. Just now we worked it. In the previous year also, the same problem was given. So please follow this. Okay. So that is problem number 15. Problem number 16 is given as, if x power y is equal to a power x, then you prove that dy by dx equal to x log a minus y by x log x. This we need to prove it. Now, function to the power function. So apply log on both sides. So if log on both sides is applied, log of x power y is equal to log of a power x can be written as y log x is equal to x log a. Now the rest is differentiation. Differentiate by using product rule. Y into differentiation of log x 1 by x plus log x multiplied by differentiation of y will be dy by dx. Fine, okay. Now x as it is. Now differentiation of this is not by product rule. Log a is a constant. Differentiation of x will be 1. So let us start simplifying. We have only one dy by dx term here. So log x multiplied by dy by dx equal to log a minus y by x. This term is shifted to right side. Now let's simplify it further. Dy by dx equal to, I will take LCM here, x log a minus 1 by x. This will be shifted to the denominator of the right hand side. And we got this answer. Hope it's clear, students. Now we have done with 2016 March. Now let's move to the next paper, 2016 June. That is supplementary examination of 2016. So 2016 June, problem number 15. Problem number 15 is given as, if y is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square, then find dy by dx. Right, not at all difficult. The inverse problem, cos inverse is there. This should be converted in terms of cos. So simple task, put x equal to tan theta, therefore theta equal to tan inverse x. So this will become y is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta, nothing but cos inverse of cos 2 theta. Eliminate this 2, theta is there, and the theta value will be tan inverse x. So 2 tan inverse x, the simplest form of y. Now differentiate. Now so dy by dx equal to 2 multiplied by 1 by 1 plus x square, differentiation of tan inverse x. Hope you're finding it easy with the students. And now the next one, that is 2016 June only, one more problem will be there, 16th one. If y is equal to x to the power sin x, then find dy by dx. That's 2016 June, problem number 16. Function to the power function, apply log. So log y will be equal to log of x power sin x, can be written as sin x. Right, now let us differentiate this. Differentiation of log y, 1 by y dy by dx. For this apply product rule. So sin x multiplied by differentiation of log x 1 by x plus log x multiplied by differentiation of sin x will be cos x. Simplify this. Dy by dx equal to y multiplied by sin x by x plus log x multiplied by cos x. The last step is to replace y. Y value will be x to the power sin x. So far what is the things we notice? One is a problem from logarithmic differentiation will be given, or from implicit, or from inverse trigonometry. So these are the problems which will appear for 2 marks in the final examination. Fine. Now, let's move to the next. Now, the next one, 2017 March. Problem number 15. Problem number 15 is given as, if ax plus by square is equal to cos y, then find dy by dx. So purely it's a problem from implicit, because the term of y is given there, right? So we'll differentiate this. Differentiation of ax will be a by square, b is a constant, and differentiation of y square 2y multiplied by dy by x. And on the right side we have cos y. So minus sin y multiplied by dy by dx. So we have to simplify because of there are two terms of dy by dx. So 2by dy by dx plus sin y dy by dx, and you are shifting a to the right side, so minus a. So take dy by dx as common. 2by plus sin y is equal to minus a. So finally dy by dx equal to minus a by 2by plus sin. So in the same now suddenly there a problem from Rolle's theorem is also given. Rarely it happens, so they won't give Rolle's theorem problem for 2 marks. Okay, suddenly it has happened, so I'll just go through this. Problem number 16 is based on verifying Rolle's theorem. So the function is given as y is equal to x square plus 2x minus 8 in the closed interval minus 4 comma 2. So what is the condition for Rolle's theorem? First condition, it's a polynomial. Okay, so what they have mentioned, y or f of x is a polynomial. If it's a polynomial, therefore it is continuous in the closed interval minus 4 comma 2. Once it's continuous, automatically it will be differentiable. Therefore it is differentiable in the open interval minus 4 comma 2. So we need to check the third condition of Rolle's theorem. Okay, now it is given as we have to verify whether f of a is equal to f of b. Now here the value of a is minus 2 and b will be 2. So let's find out the value of f of minus 4. F of minus 4 will be minus 4 square plus 4, 2 multiplied by minus 4 minus 8. Simplify this, 16 minus 8 minus 8, and the value will be 0. Similarly you find out f of 2. F of 2 will be 2 square plus 2 into 2 minus 8, certainly the value will be 0. Therefore f of minus 4 is equal to f of 2. Still not over. Okay, now the last condition of Rolle's theorem, we have to find f dash of c should be equal to 0. So what is f of x? We have f of x is x square plus 4x minus 8. Correct, right? X square plus 2x minus 8. Differentiated, f dash of x will be 2x plus 2. So f dash of c should be what? 2c plus 2 should be equal to 0, or c will be equal to minus 2 by 2 equal to minus 1. Now finding the value of c is not enough. We have to check whether this belongs to open interval minus 4 comma 2. That means on the number line this is 0 and somewhere this is minus 4 and somewhere this will be 2. Is minus 1 is a number between minus 4 and 2? Certainly minus 4 is a number between minus 4 and 2. So therefore we say that minus 1 belongs to minus 4 comma 2. All the conditions of Rolle's theorem are satisfied. Hence Rolle's theorem is verified. Okay students, now let's move on to the next. 2017 June, there is a supplementary paper. So under that, problem number 15. Problem number 15, it's been given as differentiate sin x whole power x with respect to x. So name is not given to us, so we'll go into call. So let me call y is equal to sin x whole power x, function to the power function. So log will be applied. So log of sin x whole to the power x can be written as x multiplied by log of sin x. Now differentiate by using this one is direct, so 1 by y dy by dx. This do it by product rule, so x multiplied by log of sin x, 1 by sin x multiplied by cos x, first for log then for sin, plus log of sin x multiplied by differentiation of x will be 1. So let's go for further simplification. Dy by dx equal to y multiplied by x, cos x by sin x will be cot x, plus log of sin x. The last step, replace the value of y. Y is sin x to the power x. So it's a problem based on logarithmic differentiation. That's problem number 15. Now problem number 16, they have given 2x plus 3y is equal to sine y, then find dy by dx. Right, so let us differentiate this. Implicit differentiation, because terms of y are given to us. Differentiation of 2x will be 2, 3y will be 3 multiplied by dy by dx equal to sine y is cos y multiplied by dy by dx. So let us collect the terms of dy by dx to one side. So this can be written as 2 is equal to cos y multiplied by dy by dx. I am shifting this to right side. Minus 3 multiplied by dy by dx. Let us take dy by dx common. So the remaining will be cos y minus 3. So that should be shifted to left hand side. Hence dy by dx can be written as 2 by cos y minus 3. Okay students, now let's move to the next. Now let's go to 2018. In 2018, problem number 15. Problem number 15 is given as differentiate x power sin x with respect to x. So notice it's a problem based on log differentiation. So y is equal to x to the power sin x, or log y will be log of x to the power sin x. So this can be written as sin x multiplied by log x by using the property. Fine. Okay. Now the differentiation starts. Differentiation of log y, 1 by y dy by dx, product rule, sin x multiplied by 1 by x plus log x multiplied by cos x. So finally dy by dx equal to y multiplied by sin x by x plus log x multiplied by cos x. Students, please take care. You need to substitute the value of y in the last step. Don't stop it here, because I am stopping here, so you also don't do it. So y value has to be replaced in the next step. Clear? So that is problem number 15. Now if you go to problem number 16, we have already done this, so I will not solve it once again. Problem number 16 is x square plus xy plus y square is equal to 100, then find dy by dx. I have already explained how to solve it, so please go through this.